The crew drifts over the frozen river, scanning the twisted wreckage. They all know the truth. This is a recovery mission, not a rescue. No one survived the fiery crash, and the plane lies in shattered pieces, swallowed by dark water. But there is one witness, one that can reveal everything about the disaster. It lies at the bottom of the river waiting to be found, and if the team can get it, it might unlock the truth and potentially save other planes and countless lives from the same fate. But what exactly is the black box, and why is it the only thing that can survive a plane crash? Find out on today's episode of the Infographics Show. How does an airplane black box work? Flying used to be a pretty hazardous activity, with plane crashes being commonplace, but advances in aviation safety mean it's now proportionally the safest way to travel. But the worst can still happen, as became clear in early 2025 when a plane carrying 67 people collided with a military aircraft near Washington, D.C. Not long after that, a small medical transport plane crashed near Philadelphia shortly after takeoff, likely due to mechanical failure. Both tragedies, the deadliest U.S. airplane incidents in over 20 years, left people questioning the safety of air travel and searching for answers. And those answers come from one source, or sometimes two. The black box is a term everyone recognizes, but its proper name is actually the flight recorder, and it's the source of all the data about the flight. Despite being referred to as a single item, it's actually made up of two separate devices: the flight data recorder, which records at least 88 specific data points about the flight, as well as the cockpit voice recorder, which captures all the conversations of the pilot and co-pilot throughout the flight. This gives a thorough picture of any possible mechanical failures and any possible human failures. And after a plane crash, it's usually the only thing that survives. So what's the secret sauce here? How are these devices so hardy? It's about building up a layer of protection. At the core, there are memory boards with recorded data. But as anyone who's tried to keep a younger brother away from their game discs knows, it's easy for highly technical objects to break. So first, the boards are wrapped in aluminum, and then they're surrounded by heat-protected silica, which will help it survive the intense fires of a plane crash. But we're just getting started, because they'll need to be resistant to crush damage as well. The silica coating is then given a half-inch coating of either stainless steel or, more recently, titanium. The result is something compact, portable, but incredibly durable, even in the worst-case scenario. But that might not be the biggest surprise about the black box. If you ask the average person what they know about the black box, they would probably say it's black and a box. And neither are actually true. It looks a little more like a cylinder attached to two large pieces of metal, resembling an air compressor. As for the black part of the equation, most of the time the search and rescue team is looking through brackish ocean or lake water, and something black wouldn't stand out. So flight recorders are actually mandated to be painted bright orange, which is something you don't see too often underwater. So why is it called a black box? Well, it's probably because it's easier to say and it's more memorable. Bright orange flight recorder doesn't exactly roll off the tongue, but the term is more of a relic of history than anything else. In the pre-digital era, the flight data was recorded onto magnetic tape. That necessitated a much blockier design that looked a little more like a briefcase. The fireproof box was painted black to protect the metal and prevent it from rusting. The term black box was made popular by the British during World War II, and it continued to this day. Only a few of those old-school models still exist and are slated for replacement. The best place to see one of them is a museum. But it's not just the aesthetic that's changed. The level of data that can be picked up by these data recorders is much more advanced than it used to be. The flight data recorder can pick up not only things like airspeed, altitude, and every piece of equipment on the plane, but it can also record disruptions on the plane. It's pretty common for flight attendants to joke that the black box will be able to tell if anyone still has their cell phone on at takeoff. But if anything actually went wrong because of that, well, chances are, the passenger responsible wouldn't be around to answer for it. Of course, there are two people on board whose actions matter more than anyone else's. While most plane crashes are due to either mechanical failure or outside interference, the pilot and co-pilot are the key to keeping the plane in the air, and they can be the difference between a hard landing and a crash landing. Just ask Chelsea Sully Sullenberger, whose plane lost both engines when it was hit by a flock of geese. Facing catastrophic failure, he pulled off a risky Hudson River landing that saw everyone survive, and it became known as the Miracle on the Hudson. It was his critical decision-making that made it all possible, and it was all recorded on the cockpit voice recorder. Unlike the main flight data recorder, the cockpit voice recorder doesn't cover the entire flight, especially if it's a longer flight. It captures everything said in the front cabin, but it only captures 2 hours of data. It only used to be a half an hour, but advances in technology made it possible to cover more. Once the two-hour limit is reached, the earlier conversations are recorded over. This might seem like critical data being lost, but it's actually not a large risk. the odds are high that whatever happened in the front cockpit to cause a plane to suffer a failure happened in the last 2 hours of the flight. It's key that these devices survive, which means that before it gets on a plane, it's time to have some fun. There's only one way to know if a black box will survive a plane crash, and that is to crash a plane. But that's a pretty expensive hobby, and there aren't enough planes lying around to destroy. So the factories that make the black boxes do their best to put it through its paces, using other methods. This is some of the most intensive testing any piece of equipment goes through. The process includes being crushed with 5,000 pounds per square inch of hydraulic pressure, and then being put inside a 2,000 degree Fahrenheit fireball for an hour. The black box is also shot out of an air cannon toward an aluminum target, mimicking the effects of a high-speed plane crash. And after all of that, it's just getting started. The next phase of the test is to drop it into a pressurized tank of salt water, mimicking the pressure and corrosive effect of the seawater. It also has to survive an environment resembling 20,000 feet under the sea for 24 hours, followed by 30 days submerged in salt water. Next, it's hit with a 500-pound weight with a sharp pin attached to it to make sure it's not vulnerable to puncture damage. And if it survives all of that, it goes through diagnostic tests to ensure that all of its data hasn't been compromised. And then and only then it's ready to graduate and become an official flight recorder. And the black box has a few other advantages to help it survive. The box is near indestructible, and it's likely to survive a crash. That means search teams will probably still be searching for a small tech device in a massive body of water. But there is something built in to make it a little easier. The black box has a handle attached to it, but it's actually the underwater homing beacon. And that means that even if the plane crashes over the ocean, it will emit a signal every second for up to 30 days. It can transmit from a depth of 14,000 feet underwater. Once the box is rescued from the briny depths, it's transported in a cooler to prevent any damage or rust from the sudden exposure to air. Most people would probably assume the black boxes are stored in the cockpit. After all, that is where the cockpit audio recorder gets its data, and it would make sense for them to be together. But actually, the recorders aren't the ones that are doing the active recording. That's the job of the Flight Data Acquisition Unit, or FDAU, which is found under the cockpit. The FDAU collects the data and instantaneously transmits it to the storage devices located in the tail of the plane, which is considered the most damage-resistant area of the plane. So the whole plane is wired with the data transmitters that provide the information stored in the black box. And that's led to some fascinating reveals about famous plane crashes. When it comes to recovering black boxes after plane crashes, nothing is foolproof. When it came to the DC plane crash in January 2025, the devices were found in the Potomac fairly quickly. While the flight data recorder was in good condition, the water had gotten into the cockpit voice recorder. Luckily, the data wasn't damaged, but even the slightest bit of damage can compromise a black box. And as every plane crash is different, it's impossible to account for everything that can happen in a disaster. But the black boxes that do survive can shed some major light. One of the most crucial and disturbing pieces of data recovered from a black box is often the pilot's final words. In many cases, the last transmission is a desperate mayday, if there is even time to react. But in other instances, the cockpit voice recorder can reveal whether the crash was a tragic accident, a hijacking, or even deliberate sabotage from within the cockpit. Other pilots may even have some composure to go out with some memorable words, like the doomed pilot of Pacific Southwest Flight 182, which crashed in San Diego in 1978. His last words were, "Brace yourself, Ma, I love you." And of course, the black box was key in uncovering the truth of the most famous air disaster of all time. The September 11, 2001 attacks saw three planes hit their intended targets in New York and Washington, and one crash in a field in Pennsylvania. Because this was a routine plane crash and it didn't hit a building, the black box survived and recorded key parts of the struggles that ensued in the plane. It helped to expose many of the heroes who fought the hijackers that day before the plane was ultimately brought down in Shanksville. It became the plane on that fateful day that we know the most about. But unfortunately, there is another factor in whether black boxes work: human error. The Philadelphia plane crash in January 2025 wasn't among the deadliest air disasters, but it was still a tragedy. The medical transport plane went down, killing all six people on board, along with one person on the ground and two dozen more injured. But coming right on the heels of the DC disaster, it had many people worried that something was broken in US air travel. The plane crashed right after takeoff, seemingly free-falling without interference from a foreign object. People wanted answers about whether there was a maintenance issue or something else. There was just one problem. When the cockpit voice recorder was recovered from the wreckage, it was intact, but there was no data. Nothing. In fact, it turned out that the recorder likely wasn't working for several years. While the plane's crew seemed to be well-versed in flying a plane like this, the equipment seemed to have been out of date. And if this critical part of the plane infrastructure wasn't working, many wondered if other key parts may have been left to fail as well. But data on the crash is going to be limited because the black box wasn't recording. And when the data is recovered from a crash site, it becomes a case of sorting through it to find that one crucial detail hidden like a needle in a haystack. As soon as the data is downloaded, the air crash investigators get to work, combing through every little detail. While the cockpit voice recorder is best known for capturing conversations between the pilot and co-pilot, it records far more than just voices. It picks up hundreds of data points, including engine sounds, alarms, and any unexpected noises in the cockpit. If the plane crashed unexpectedly, any of them can be a clue as to what went wrong. These investigators are trained to recognize key sounds that could mean a system failure. Additionally, conversations with air traffic controllers are heavily scrutinized. The investigators will painstakingly create a transcript of every sound on the recording, which can take up to a week before it's submitted. And that's just the first part of the data. The flight data recorder has a much more complex set of data available. While all recorders collect at least 88 parameters that all planes are required to monitor, the most advanced models keep track of over 1,000 data points. It carries up to 25 hours of information, longer than any flight that currently exists on the planet. That means the data will include the remaining data from the previous flight, which can be helpful if the issue was pre-existing. And after the data is analyzed, computer systems can create a computer-generated video reconstructing the flight, showing where things may have gone wrong. And like all technology, it's come a very long way. Almost as soon as there were planes, people were interested in learning more about them. The origins of the black box come from two different continents. First, in the 1930s, French aviation expert François Houssonneau started work on a device that would record the most basic parameters, such as speed and altitude. The technology for computer recordings didn't exist back then, so the data would be printed onto photographic film. It was key information, but it also wasn't particularly durable if things went wrong. And so, for the next step, we had to go down under. Australian scientist David Warren was taking aviation safety seriously in the 1950s. This was the dawn of the air travel age, as jetliners ferrying large groups long distances were starting to become popular, and Warren knew all too well that it could be perilous. He had lost his father in a plane crash in 1934. When the world's first commercial jet airliner, the Comet, crashed, Warren began developing the cockpit voice recorder. Officials were skeptical, but Warren kept working on ways to make the device durable, and eventually it was installed in airliners worldwide. But despite how effective it is, the black box does have some serious weaknesses. It's most useful when people have a good idea of where it can be found. If a plane crashes off the coast or over solid ground, the black box can usually be located in a hurry. But today, countless flights are transoceanic jaunts, ferrying people from the US coasts to Tokyo or London. And if a plane goes down over one of the oceans, that leaves a massive area to cover in the search, even if the general area is known. Complicating things, the depths of the ocean in those areas are likely to be so extreme that no signal could get through, and so many black boxes disappear without a trace, along with the plane in some cases. But the scientists and engineers aren't done yet. The black box has come a long way since it was a light, tight box recording film. Today, most black boxes are still closed-circuit devices existing solely within the plane, but we live in a digital world where file transfers and internet connections are instantaneous. Most planes will have Wi-Fi now, which means everyone on board can keep up with their social media, torment the rest of the plane by playing Baby Shark on loop for their baby, or watch an episode of the Infographics Show. So why can't the black box evolve in the same way? In this new system, the data recorder wouldn't be storing its data in the device in the tail, but using it to transmit the data via satellite broadcasting. It would be immediately transferred to databanks where it could be stored if needed in the event of a crash or other issues that might occur during the flight. The drawbacks for this plan are that the satellites would need enormous bandwidth to record all the data for every flight. It could also potentially open the data up to hacking if the security of the satellites was breached. Another option would make it more likely for the black box to survive. The aviation company Airbus is working on a tail-mounted unit that would combine the flight data recorder, cockpit voice recorder, and emergency transmitter into one. If a crash landing is detected, the unit would automatically eject, avoiding the crushing impact of the wreckage. And instead of sinking to the ocean floor, it would be designed to float, making it easier to locate and speeding up recovery efforts. More importantly, it could help rescuers find any survivors. And this could avoid some of the most infamous flight disasters of all time. airplanes disappearing without a trace isn't new. After all, the vanishing of Amelia Earhart during the early days of aviation is one of the most fascinating mysteries out there. But even more disturbing is the fact that it happened again in 2014. Malaysian Airlines Flight 370 vanished on a flight from Kuala Lumpur to Beijing, a relatively short flight along a busy aircraft corridor, and it took 239 people with it. Despite exhaustive searches, the wreckage was never found, and neither were any remains. Only a small amount of debris believed to belong to the plane was found, making it likely that it had crashed. But one potential solution could avoid all of the heartache and uncertainty. Tying in with Airbus's proposal for advanced data tracking, the company is looking to add autonomous distress tracking devices on all of its commercial aircraft. This would ensure that not only is the plane transmitting its flight data at all times, but that it's transmitting its location and would not disappear in a distress situation. While this might not have been able to save the doomed Malaysian Airlines flight, it's likely that the location of the crash would have been known much earlier, providing closure to the families of the victims. But some people might ask, isn't there a better solution? The black box is the hardiest part of the plane, able to survive a crash with only minor damage. So some smart guys on the internet asked, well, why not make just the entire plane out of the black box? After all, if it crashed, it would remain intact, right? It seems like such a simple solution that it's amazing no one has done it before. Surely the big aviation companies should just start rolling off crash-proof, heat-proof titanium-coated planes that would be soaring through the air in years to come. And if you're thinking it's probably not that simple, you're right. The black box is designed to survive crashes. It has one role: to be compact and durable no matter what happens. But it's not designed to fly. The main strength of the device is in its density, being carefully designed to provide layer after layer of protection. That's the furthest thing from being aerodynamic. The substances in the black box are also used in planes, including stainless steel and titanium, but they're used in much smaller portions to keep things light. And the strength of the black box comes from its construction, not its materials. And if you did build a plane out of this material, things would go very wrong quickly. To start with, the plane would be way too heavy to take off and stay in the air. The high concentration of titanium involved in the plane would make it an incredibly dense machine that would struggle to even get off the ground. Its massive weight would demand enormous amounts of fuel, limiting it to short, impractical flights. And then the process of bringing it to a stop would be equally tricky. The sheer momentum of such a heavy object would require an extra long runway, while the impact of touchdown could damage both the landing gear and the runway itself. But at least everyone on board is safe, right? Nope. While the plane is tough, the humans on board definitely are not. And so we would have hundreds of people enduring high-speed sudden stops from inside a titanium tube, which would result in massive blunt force trauma to everyone inside in the event of a crash. So while the plane might land looking relatively intact, the odds are that opening the door to this hypothetical black box plane would be a horror show. Probably best to keep those amazing little devices as they are. Durable, powerful, and very small. Do you think black box technology is advanced enough, or should there be more innovations to make crash investigations easier? What other improvements would you like to see in aviation safety? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. Want to know more about the most famous missing flight of all time? Check out what really happened to the missing Malaysian Airlines Flight 370, or watch how luxury crews turned into nightmare for passengers, for a look at how another form of transportation became a fiasco.